Welcome to Iran Air Engineering and Maintenance Hangar located at Mehrabad Airport. As you see behind me, there is an aircraft Boeing 747SP with call sign of Alpha Alpha. And this hangar is used for heavy and light maintenance checks like as A, C and S. And this aircraft is in the hangar for the C check. This also check including for section 41 inspection, which is used to very detailed inspection of the structural elements connecting section 41 to section 42 aircraft to detect any structural damage or cracks during the operation. Maintenance checks intervals are based on flight cycles. Our checks are depending on the maintenance steering group package, which is used for aircraft checks. And as their package, every 300 hours of flight is needed for a check called A check. And every 10 A check, we have to check the aircraft, which is called C check. These checks are used to detail inspection the aircraft throughout the aircraft for the engines, structures, landing gear systems, and cabin systems, all for a better and safe operation of the aircraft during the next flights. We have light maintenance, which is called transit and daily and weekly checks, which are checked in the line maintenance, and heavy checks such as A and C and S checks, which are based on the maintenance hangars to be accomplished. This aircraft has 16,000 flight cycles and need section 41 inspection, which is included in a package called C check for this aircraft. And during the grounding of aircraft in the maintenance hangar, we use inspections and all inspection tasks to detect any abnormality and system component failure for the safe operation of the aircraft. As you see, there is another 747SP aircraft called Alpha Delta behind me, and this aircraft is under check for turbine and compressor of engines for safe operation. This aircraft has a D-check recently performed, and after that there is several checks, A and C checks, we use to confirm the safe operation of the aircraft. As you see here, the engine is suspended from the aircraft because this engine is checked, and there is a program for replacing by another one, which is overhauled by the engine shop. All the components and the engine components and aircraft components have a lifetime, and the production and planning plans for the replacement of them at the exact time, or we check it before the exact time to find any abnormality, and unconditioned checks to replace the faulty item with the new one or newly overhauled components. Okay, let's go inside and have a look inside to see what's going on inside. Welcome on board Alpha Delta. As you see, there is no major change inside the cabin because there is just a daily check for the interior of the aircraft, and it will become ready for the next flight after engines are checked and released for the service by the maintenance crew. Normally for engine replacement, actually it depends on the condition of aircraft, because if we are in a hurry, we have to change it faster and test it and back aircraft to the operation as soon as possible. But normally it takes 12 hours for us remove, install and rigging and check the bleed system, check the fuel system, ignition system, and finally run it and take the power assurance tests which is needed for the release of the engines for the next flight. But for one single engine, after normal replacement, as the maintenance manual procedures, we have several tests, 15-16 test numbers, which are used for the check of the several systems like the fuel, bleed system, ignition system, and all done by one, and finally we use takeoff power to confirm the power assurance needed for takeoff and bleed closure, and all these tests are written in the maintenance manuals. We use the references and we check the engine, and sometimes we have to rig it again because some indication maybe we found it during test is enough, or we have failure, or we have to increase the fuel for trimming. We call it trimming. We use the special tools for engine vane control system check, for take the most power of the aircraft at the safe conditions, and finally after engine change, crew will come and accept the engine for the flight. We have several different steps to test. It becomes with dry motoring. After dry motoring, ignition checks. After ignition check, we have starting checks with fuel and ignition. Idle check, we call it idle check. Engine running with idle check. After idle check, we have engine needed for takeoff, which needs more power, RPM increasing, fuel increasing, and we have to place the aircraft in a special place because we can't do it over here. Blast and noise, everything become very heavy. We change the aircraft position and we test the aircraft engines for takeoff power assurance, we calling reverse systems. During taxi we use them, we use the engines during taxi when we are transferring to the hot spot for takeoff power check, and several checks as requested by the package are done over here, and after final trimming we taxi the aircraft again to the parking position, and that's it. As you see, this space is especially called prayers room, and which is unique in you cannot find anywhere else, just in the Iran Air 747 aircrafts. This space is especially divided by this partition, and this monitor always shows the direction to the Mecca, which is used for the Muslims for the direction for the praying.